people and 62 million other Americans are listening to me right now, because less than 3% of you people read books. Because less than 15% of you read newspapers. Because the only truth you know is what you get over this tube. Right now, there is a whole, an entire generation that never knew anything that didn't come out of this tube. This tube is the gospel, the ultimate revelation. This tube can make or break presidents, popes, prime ministers. This tube is the most awesome goddamn force in the whole godless world. And woe is us if it ever falls into the hands of the wrong people. And when the 12th largest company in the world controls the most awesome goddamn propaganda force in the whole godless world, who knows what shit will be peddled for truth on this network? So you listen to me. Listen to me. Television is not the truth. Television is a goddamn amusement park. Television is a circus, a carnival, a traveling troupe of acrobats, storytellers, dancers, singers, jugglers, sideshow freaks, lion tamers, and football players. We're in the boredom-killing business. So if you want the truth, go to God. Go to your gurus. Go to yourself. Because that's the only place you're ever going to find any real truth. Man, you're never going to get any truth from us. We'll tell you anything you want to hear. We lie like hell. We'll tell you that Kojak always gets the killer, and that nobody ever gets cancer in Archie Bunker's house. And no matter how much trouble the hero is in, don't worry, just look at your watch. At the end of the hour, he's going to win. We'll tell you any shit you want to hear. We deal in illusions, man. None of it is true. But you people sit there day after day, night after night, all ages, colors, creeds. We're all you know. You're beginning to believe the illusions we're spinning here. You're beginning to think that the tube is reality and that your own lives are unreal. You do whatever the tube tells you. You dress like the tube. You eat like the tube. You raise your children like the tube. You even think like the tube. This is mass madness, you maniacs. In God's name, you people are the real thing. We are the illusion. So turn off your television sets. Turn them off now. Turn them off right now. Turn them off and leave them off. Turn them off right in the middle of the sentence I'm speaking to you now. Turn them off.
One man that said, I would like to talk to my friend that died 6 months ago. But I don't want him to appear. Just want to talk to him. Because he says, I don't trust you talking to my friend for me. So the medium says, let me inquire of the spirit. Yeah, the spirit will talk with you. And that big masculine voice was heard in the place. Says, hi, Frank. It's nice of you to ask for me to talk with you. And they had a little chat. And after it was over, Frank says, this is the greatest thing on earth, to be able to talk with the spirits of the dead. Then the medium said, we have a very special surprise tonight for you people. A spirit will manifest itself openly here in a few minutes. And it's like a big gust of wind hit the building and right through the wall. Now, the lights weren't terribly bright, but they were like living room lights. A couple of floor lamps and maybe some of these. And that translucent being seemed to come right out of the wall.
How did you feel right at that moment?
It's almost like my heart stopped a little bit. Okay. You know, very weird feeling. It was a lady in a beautiful evening gown, floor length. And she said to Mary, my dear sister, you are so wonderful to have asked for me. And Mary fainted and fell right off her chair on the floor. And a couple of guys jumped up. And the priest mentioned there's thousands of spirit worshippers in only different societies of spirit worshippers in this world. But he says, we are the elite. We know the real truth about the master and his angels. And they are not hideous-looking beings. They are gorgeous creatures. And from the paintings that they had on the walls of that worship room, they were unique beings. Especially there was a painting full-length painting of the fallen Lucifer above his altar. And that was very fascinating because he looked like a man of great intellect, high forehead. The way that he looked with his eyes, the way he had the eyes looking, it gave you a depth of perception of somebody that is very, very knowledgeable and
powerful.
And powerful, yeah.
Ted Gunderson, FBI veteran, former head of the regional office in Los Angeles. Is there a network of these satanic murderers in this country, do you allege?
I cannot say that there's a network of satanic murderers. I can say that based on information furnished to me by confidential sources and informants, based on interviews with dozens of survivors from the satanic operations through the years, satanic beliefs, etc., I can say that there is a network of these people across the country who are very active. They have their own rest and relaxation farm. They are in contact with each other. It ties in loosely to the drug operation. It ties into motorcycle gangs, and it goes on and on. They have their own people who are specialized in surveillances and photography and in assassinations.
Why do you think there is no attention being paid to that ritual aspect of this case?
You're in the heart of America, the Bible Belt. And we hate to think that people like that live next door to us. We're turning our backs on acting like it doesn't happen. We're putting our hands over our eyes as if it didn't occur here, that it was just a murder.
This is Detective Lee Orr of the neighboring Kansas City, Kansas Police Department.
Do you believe there is a satanic aspect to these horrible crimes?
Yes, I'm sure there is, yes.
We've also had contact with people that have come out of the occult, Satan worship, who have definitely made statements and who I've interviewed that state that Mr. Verdello was involved at a higher level than most in the...
Here perhaps are some leads for investigators to follow. Item: police reports obtained by us show local authorities have long been aware that devil worshippers were conducting large-scale ceremonies in the Kansas City area. Item: this young man says he was an eyewitness to a sexual orgy at Verdella's house, one with heavy satanic overtones. And item: this woman claims she met Verdella through her former husband, a high priest in a local satanic cult.
We were at a meeting in the area, and he was up on the platform in a throne, which symbolizes that sacrifice at that particular meeting was for him, was done for him.
So he was in an exalted position. He was a VIP.
Yes, he was.
What happened there at that ceremony?
There was a young man killed, a young boy. He was 16 years old.
Did you ever tell the police about any of this?
No, I didn't.
Why?
People don't believe you when you talk about these things. People just do not believe these things happen.
Okay, I killed everybody since day one. I murdered them all. I'm God and I've killed everybody.
Or the devil.
Or the devil, yeah. You could use the word devil or demons or whatever you want to call it.
Mostly the devil in your world, isn't it?
Well, okay, I'll play. There's no game I can't play. There's no game I haven't played.
You are the devil. Yeah.
Okay, I'll be the devil then.
Along with Hitler, cult leader Charles Manson is today's top satanic celebrity.
Yeah, I chopped up 9 hogs. And I'm going to chop up some more, you I'm going to kill you as many as I can. I'm going to pile you up to the sky.
Responsible for at least 9 ritual murders, Manson is revered by many modern-day devil worshippers who have adopted his philosophy of the mass extermination of those they consider unfit to live.
we would like to see most of the human race killed off because it is unworthy. It is unworthy of the gift of life.
Nicholas Schreck visited Charlie at San Quentin, keeps a picture of his hero on his apartment wall, and displays a lock of Manson's hair as if it were a sacred relic.
A bloodbath would be a cleansing and a purification of a planet that has been dirtied and degraded for too long.
David Berkowitz, the son of Sam, was also a Satanist, the serial killer who terrorized New York while murdering five young